Welcome back to The Legend of Master Hunter. Last time we were in the sewer ways, and we got rid of this whole central area, and we also had a bit of a side detour up in this area. We dealt with this mess, which actually didn't turn out to be too bad. And, Beethro, you cut that out. Seriously? Alright, come on. So let's see here. So we've got open and also open. I don't see any obvious place to kill the serpent, at least in here, so we're going to need to kill it on the eyes, most likely. Which is fine, that's established smite mastery technique right there. So tell you what, I'm just going to go right back out, and then hopefully I can lure the serpent down here if the timing line's up right. It's not. What I'm going to do is I'm going to fix that and make it... I'm going to delay it by a couple moves, and then maybe that'll help, or by a few more. Maybe this will make the, that'll make the serpent preference line up. Alright, so that takes care of our serpent problem. I don't think we need it for this area, because we can just sneak back here. And, we got plenty of room, so there you have it. I mean, you can kill a snake in a lot of different ways here. You could even, like, wake up an eye and then lure it back here, and then that would work. But, or, you know, you could just chop up all the eyes and kill it down here. That works, too. Any way you want to do it. And a solid wall. Alright, I guess we were supposed to... Yeah, we did this room backwards. We were supposed to be harassed by evil eyes while we desperately tried to find a spot to kill the serpent in, but, I don't know, we did it the easy way, so that's all cool. What is not cool, however, is that we are gonna have to deal with this mess. Not happy about that, but, you know, that's the way the cookie crumbles sometimes. Or, you know, the cotton candy melts in your mouth, or... I don't know, whatever people is say, you know, just... You gotta wade through a giant mass of wubbas. That's what we gotta do here. So I guess in order to steel myself for this, I'll have some therapeutic, some good old therapeutic explosions. Alright, take that, you wubbas. The thing about these two-length fuses, you gotta be a little bit more direct in how you run away from them. Three, you know, you can get away with just about whatever, but, you know, two, you have to take a pretty specific path away from the bomb to not blow yourself up. Alright, so you gotta go back out into the main path for a little bit, and then go down here, and that's how you get into the bottom part. Okay. I didn't want to do this if I could avoid it, but I guess there's no helping it. So we're gonna have to... I guess we kind of want to lure some out like this, and then get a few more out, but this is getting clogged already. So sure, we can get a lot out like that, but we're not quite going to get all of them. Except I think we just got enough here. Yeah, now we've got enough, because now we can sneak through here. And sure, might as well save a demo of that too, why not? Alright, so looks like after we solve this room, we'll be able to backtrack out of here. So again, we won't have to do this again. Alright, now what's happening here? This is all clogged up. It looks like four roaches killed some roach queens in here, and then the rest of the snake friends followed in, and, you know, it's a traffic jam. But fortunately, unlike in the real world, you're allowed to cut up the cars with your giant sword, so... Yeah, I have no idea where this is going. Can you blame me, though? The thing about rooms like this is there's the slow way to do them and the fast way. The slow, safe way is to just kill as many rattlesnakes as you can before, you know, segments before you let any of them out, which gives you the maximum amount of space to deal with, you know, once you release multiple rattlesnakes, then you'll have plenty of room to dodge around them. But that's a slow way because that, even though you might be killing one segment per turn, you're not freeing the rest of the rattlesnakes, so you're going to have to do, like, backtracking moves where you don't kill a segment at all. So to go fast, you want to release them all at once so that they're, you know, they go all over the place and it's all chaotic. And, you know, somehow input the magic series of moves that lets you kill one, like, every two turns or something. But then you don't waste any time at all, you just kind of plow through them. You'll get more chances to do that later on, of course. Alright, so what's going on here? Okay, so we want to blow this all up, but we want to hit this at some point. What opens this? Just this. So I think we could dodge this, probably. Yeah, because this is just a trap. If we go in here, we just get trapped, so we have to survive this. So we do that, and then we do that, sure. So I think we might as well, wait until the spawn and then do this. Do we want them to spawn? If we don't, they get trapped in here, but we can still deal with them anyway, so that's fine. Yeah, so I don't think letting them... Yeah, because we're going to have to turn around. They're going to get away anyway, and then these roaches are going to harass us, so... Yeah, we might as well just not let them spawn. So sure, that's been done. Except we might not actually want to kill these, maybe? Yeah, we kind of do. Yeah, so we'll go around the long way, except we don't actually... Yeah, we'll go around the long way again. Yeah, so that's fine. Those roaches get caught in there, and then we lure them out, and that's all good. I don't think we need the roach queens in this east section here. So that's all good. Sure, we'll drop these, just to keep us safe. And then... we don't want them to get in there, but it's okay if they go here. Yeah, that's fine. We just don't want them to spawn any roaches. There's nothing to do here, so just, do that. Give ourselves maximum goblin killing room. I mean, again, we could have tried to stand our ground here, but shapes like this are awkward, so might as well just run away. I mean, the architect is letting us do it, so we might as well. Similarly, I don't see what we would need the wubbas for, so let's just leave them behind. They ain't our friends. And then we'll wait for these to spawn, but then lure them back down, except we can't. Okay. Alright, so... but this is a toggle. Alright, so hold on. So is there any way to deal with these without any additional help? Is the question. This did open, but there was no reason to kill all the rattlesnakes. So maybe we need a rattlesnake in here, but is there anything we can do without having to use a rattlesnake? So let's say we, like, wait for them to spawn. Then what happens? They both go in like that, so that gets rid of the movement order problem, but one still winds up in here. Alright, so yeah, we want to keep a rattlesnake alive, which means restarting the whole room. Oh well, did not see that ahead of time, but, that's what happens sometimes. You don't spot these clever tricks ahead of time. So we'll not kill all the snakes, we just need to kill, most of them. How long would we need one to be? It never gets... Yeah, whatever snake ends up here gets blown up, so... We don't actually need a very long one. Just, like, three or fewer. Or not fewer, more. Because if it's too short, that's no good. You know, if it's two, then that's not long enough. And if it's one, it's already dead because it's just a head with legs. Tell you what, is there any way I can... Let's do it like this. So what's gonna happen now... those will be let out, but all four of these are hedging themselves in. Yeah, you guys just go up there, sure. And, let's not kill them and just... have them run the snake racetrack and clog up that thing. But the problem is, that's not gonna blow them all up though. Alright, I guess we can't do that. So in that case, we're not gonna kill all of them. We're not going to let it do that. As funny as that was, that's not actually right. So what we're going to do instead is we're going to just leave one alive. Get rid of that. And then we're going to use the old drive the snake east technique. I'm not sure if I've shown this off on video now, so here's a good opportunity to do that. What I want to do in my... Like, here's my ultimate strategy, is I want to drive a snake east along this row, because what I want is for the tail to be, like, in around here or so, and the head to be here. And the easiest way to do that would be to put the head here and the tail here and have it go downwards. So, what if there was an easy way to just make it go east forever without having Beethro over here? Well, here's what you do. You're in an open area. This happens a lot. You have plenty of area. You got plenty of room above the column in question. So we're going to have the snake go here, and it's in horizontal preference. Now what we're going to do is, since it's to the east of us, this is the easiest way to do it. Usually you want it on your east, but you can have it in other directions as well. So we're going to send it east by making it go vertically down. And now its tail segment is here. So this works even if you have a two-link snake. All you need is one tail segment here. It's already in vertical mode, so we needed one vertical move to do this to lure it into going like this, or, you know, any other, like, combination of obstacles, like if we had one here and here to make it go there. All you need is for it to be in vertical mode when you go north like this, and it's blocked somehow. And that will send it east. Now you go back down, and you stand behind the head, and you wait. And because it has no other way of getting to you, and you're in the same row as it, it's going to keep going east forever, no matter what. Well, until it runs into something. So you don't need much room to do this at all, in fact. You know, you have way more room here than you actually need. But just a quick two-step, just send it down, go back up. It can't go up, so it'll go east. Step back down, make it keep going east. That is a good tool in your toolbox. So, now that we've clogged up this arrow trap, now these queens won't run away from us, and we're good to go. We'll blow this up, this will blow up the snake as well, and we should be good, I think. Now we just have to redo the rest of the room. Okay, we're back, and as you can see, hopefully, our rattlesnake trap has worked beautifully. Unfortunately, we don't get to blow up the wubbas like I was hoping to, but... We'll just leave them trapped in here forever until some other Delver comes along. Alright, so that was kind of clever. You know, you thought that this was just a horde segment, but actually, you know, it was a key part of the whole thing. What does this orb do? No comment. Alright, so what could be waiting for us at the end, I wonder? Well, we've got a, you know, nice backtrack passage. That opens up, you know, all this stuff, which means that you can get right back to the center of the room if you really need to. So, you know, you don't have to do anything, really, if you don't want to. Always remember this, kids. You can do things if you want to do them, but you have to be prepared to deal with the consequences. So, there are a bunch of co-conspirators conspirating and conspiracy-fearing up there, so... Oh. Well, I think we're run into a mud coordinator. Alright. So, what is going on here? This is gonna form a baby, and so's that. So I think we just need to hurry. These are gonna form babies all over the place. So, I think we just run for it. I don't know. That's kind of common, but I think it's just because they don't have any swords. I think that's why they run away. I mean, if they don't have a sword, there's no way they can beat you in combat, Beethro. And maybe if I cut this a little bit more efficiently, I can kill you in time. Alright, there we go. That triangular formation is not always the fastest way to kill mud, but it's a pretty good way in kind of mid-sized cases like this one, where you can get to your goal within one spawn or so. That's a pretty efficient mud-cutting technique. There are better ones, but that one is pretty good. That's the wrong bear. It should be B-E-A-R, as in to carry witness. I don't think he can hear me. Okay, so there's a decoy potion we can blow up. Sure. Yeah, sure thing. This is gonna get clogged up real fast, though. We can't get in here without blowing this up. So I think this is a race. This is gonna get clogged up real fast. Alright, what can we do about things? You know, this is an area we gain access to really quickly. We're gonna get a mud baby here. We get just one, though, and we can't stand up here. So there's no actual way to block this without just getting to it in time. This is already all pretty much as expanded as it's gonna be. This is all filled in. So I think we just need to race up here. I don't see any other course of action we can really take. Okay, so here's another thing. Do we waste time cutting this up so that it doesn't grow back over us, or do we just not worry about it? I think we just don't worry about it, because it's going to be a lot of spawns before it makes another mud baby up here. And, we'll see, though, it's going to block this in. Let's just see how short we come if we do this. If it's correct, then good. And if not, we'll gain valuable information about how strict the time limit is on this. So now I don't think we can spare the time to do anything further down here. Because this is going to be in here in two spawn cycles, and this is going to take a while to clean up. So I don't have time for that. So I'll just come back to that later. Alright, so now I'll cut all this up and then run back, I guess. Yeah, that seems good. So eventually that's going to grow over here. That's fine. This is just a one tile thing. That's okay. It would have to go all the way... Yeah, it would have to go very far away before that's a problem. So now I think we just clean up the rest of the mud. Yeah, we just need to make sure it doesn't grow that far, really, actually. So we need to hurry up a little bit more. Okay, that's good. Now we go back, double back at this. Alright, I'll be back for you later. So we'll trim this back a little bit more, just to make sure the south doesn't get clogged up. It's pretty cheap to do this, honestly. Alright, so that's gonna take forever to get out into here, and in fact, we might be able to halt it with a, Mud Baby advance. So that'll give us enough time to do these sections. Alright, so we'll leave that decoy for later. South is still fine as of now. Let's clean this up, because we need to get rid of all the tar to get this one. And we just don't want it bothering us while we're gone. Okay. So now, what we need to do is we need to make our run. We're going to need to run. We need to make that as clean as possible. So we're going to get rid of all this. And we're going to face north, and we're going to wait for the spawn cycle. Now, we're going to bolt over here, and we're going to blow up that bomb as soon as we can. I don't know the order of operations here. I think the placement occurs after the spawn, so we don't want to wait for the spawn cycle. Yeah, don't wait for the spawn cycle, because then it'll grow this. So I just want to blow this up now. Alright, sorry. Sorry, but... Okay, listen. I would love to spare you if you could only escape from your pit. I would be fine with that, but because you have trapped yourself in such a stupid place, I have to blow up these mud babies, so I'm gonna have to blow you up too. Alrighty then. I guess that's the end of the sewers, then? Probably. Wow, we're pretty deep in, actually. So, maybe this is another transition level? Half? Yeah, you're totally in this game, right?
Got it.
Oh, you. If I only had a stick, I'd shove you right into the pit. Just into the pit. Just. Alright. Alright, you stay trapped in there. I'll be back for you when I've got, you know, my hand bomb, or my ray gun, or my rocket launcher, or whatever blows up Wilma's on me. Oh boy. Am I ready for this, actually? I don't know, there's still, like, business to do in the Guilderhood, isn't there? Let's see. Yeah, this is one way, isn't it? Yeah. Maybe... And this is, like, a secret level inside a secret level? Because, like, we had to break a secret wall in order to get to the sewers? Yeah, let's leave this on a restore list, I guess. I kind of want to explore the Guilderhood a little bit more. Is there anything else we can do before we move on? Oh, nice. It put us all the way out here, so we don't have to cut all this mud again. In fact, this would have been a backtracking problem, so we go here. Nice. Kaboom! Yes. Alright, but yeah, we kind of went, like, if you remember way back in, like, a few episodes ago, we kind of went on a side path in order to get to this level in the first place, so I think we actually kind of need to go back on the main road, or maybe we don't, but I want to see what was left to see in the Guilderhood, at least, because I think there's still a few more rooms we could feasibly go to. This is just rude. You should move this Wubba so that, you know, I can actually get through here if I come from the south. But I gotta backtrack up north so that this Wubba gets stuck so I can actually go in here. But yeah, let's just remind ourselves what's left to do, because maybe we can meet up with some new people. Maybe we can get some reinforcements for dealing with this conspiracy. I mean, we did just commit murder, after all. I mean, like, actual murder of people we care about, not, like, the intruders. Hey, did you know that people were plotting a conspiracy down here? It's important news. Alright, so let's get back out of this secret tunnel. How's this gonna work? Okay, so let's put them down here, maybe, I guess? Yeah, I need, we're gonna need both of you down here, I think. Alright, so what that lets us do is it keeps this passageway completely empty. Then I can lure this one out like that, and without being trapped with a Wubba behind me like that. And let's break our way back out of the walls. So yeah, we never went west from here. Let's see what's west from here, if we can. Yeah, something opens that door, right? Yeah, let's see what we got. Oh. Okay, then. Yeah, it's a dead end. Yeah. Did we just spend too long in here? I don't know. But, yeah, okay. I guess I was meant to focus us down here. Like, is there any way to backtrack in here? Yeah, actually there is. So, yeah, I don't know what you would do if you didn't notice this. Maybe it needs to be, like, a crumbly wall or something. Alright, time well spent. I swear, this is gonna be the episode full of editing. Oh, right. Actually, we can get in here now. And yeah, there's nothing to do in here, but what about down here? I mean, sure, we can get in here. We can go in here, which actually lets us get down here. Okay. What do we got down here? It's nothing. There is not a room down there. That's a shame. This would be a great place to hide a secret, because this is exactly the kind of place you'd be poking around in. But there's no... I don't think there's anything down there. Or, like, maybe there's, like, a serpent head or something that's blocking the room that we can't... We'll have to unlock from the other edge, but that's kind of a, like, obscure Zik and Kalor kind of thing. By which I mean the architects of them. They love using that trick in their holds to block secrets. But, yeah, I forget whether there's a room down there or not. But still, kind of disappointing we can't just immediately go into a place. Which, of course, raises the question, how did the Wubba get in here? But, you know, the Wubba's already shown us that it can teleport, so I guess that's possible. I mean, it can teleport off-screen. But, I mean, if you're not looking at it, it can go anywhere. And that is a common power of many high-level monsters. Alright, so that was a big waste of time. Alright, so I guess, in accordance to tradition, we'll at least see what's in here. Did I step on that checkpoint? Yeah, I did step on that checkpoint. So, in accordance with tradition, let's at least take one peek at what's beyond the Force Arrows before we call it an episode. Oh, hi there. Didn't I see you already? Yeah, we've already got one who might be after us. You said, yeah, weakness is arrogance. Alright. So this Slayer that we let out of jail when the Steel Prison is apparently helping this one out. So, might be two Slayers after us now. But, you know, if there's two, that's not really that much worse than one, right? Yeah, there's a lot more to it than that. This is a complicated topic. For example, I am a mercenary who works for money. You don't work for money at all. You just work for the thrill of the hunt. Alright, next time I guess we're gonna be doing a whole bunch of Slayer puzzles, and seeing who hired these Slayers, and get to the bottom of this darn conspiracy, whatever it is.